Thank you, and thank you to our nominees for your willingness to serve our country in many, or most cases, once again. Ms. Gordon Haggerty, the Undersecretary of Energy for Nuclear Security, Administrator of the National Nuclear Security Administration, is one of the most consequential jobs in our government, even if it's not one of the most prominent jobs. It is truly a zero-defect, no-fail environment. You've worked in this field before. You write in your testimony about some top priorities, in particular nuclear modernization. You note with alarm, which I share, that more than half of NNSA's facilities are over 40 years old. Almost a third date back to the Manhattan Project era. Could you talk to us a little bit about your modernization plans for the infrastructure of our nuclear enterprise?
Senator Cotton, you're exactly right. And the numbers that I quoted are exactly true. In order for the United States to ensure that we have an effective nuclear deterrent depends on the National Nuclear Security Administration and DOE. And for that to happen, we must be able to modernize and have a robust, a modern, flexible, and appropriately tailored system throughout the nuclear weapons complex. In order to do that, we need reliable and sustained funding. Just for what it's worth, there's a backlog of facilities of more than $2.5 billion currently at DOE and NNSA because the facilities have not been able to be updated and maintained. In order to do that, we need to ensure that Congress provides us with the necessary resources to do so. I believe that there's a good staff over at the NNSA, our dedicated federal workforce, that will allow me, if confirmed, to be able to put together and constitute a plan of action forward. But we do not have any more time. We're long overdue for an upgrade to our facilities and modernize the nuclear weapons complex to be able to do what we can to sustain the current nuclear weapons stockpile as well as put in place the requirements for future nuclear weapons matters.
In your opinion, is the two-year budget deal on which the Senate will vote later today that provides over $160 billion over the next 2 years for defense suitable for you to execute that modernization plan?
I believe that that will be an outstanding start. But again, that will be my statements will be predicated on having reliable and consistent funding. But that will certainly go a long way. And if confirmed, I look forward to executing those missions.
Thank you. You also write that you will ensure that the nuclear security enterprise continues to employ the brightest and the best by recruiting, retaining, and growing the highly skilled workforce needed to maintain the U.S. nuclear weapons stockpile. This has obviously been something of a challenge in recent years since the end of the Cold War. Our nuclear enterprise has lost much of its longstanding expertise among individuals who have been working in our labs or in the Department of Energy or in our military. Can you talk about your plan to retain but also recruit new talented individuals?
Yes, Senator Cotton. Since my background happens to be having started out as a health physicist at Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory and also being a federal official in military application at headquarters DOE, I think I bring a unique perspective. And while I do have a number of different ideas, I know that the department and NNSA have gone out and tried to recruit highly technically and highly qualified workforce for the future. However, I do have a number of plans. I'm really excited to get out to colleges and universities because I think there is a real untapped potential to show young people that they can actually commit to supporting our national security and looking at opportunities in math and science and STEM programs especially to be able to support and contribute to our national security. I think that's untapped potential. I also think that there's another opportunity that perhaps is a mid-career opportunity. There are a lot of people that are burned out, I believe, that are working their jobs every day, maybe even in Silicon Valley, and we can give them opportunities that perhaps they wouldn't otherwise have. Challenges in working in high-performance computing, working in cutting-edge science. It's a wonderful opportunity, and I have to say I've had a very rewarding career, and because I've spent all of it in national security, like I said, at one of the laboratories and as a federal official, I would be excited to go out and speak to others about perhaps coming and joining us at the DOE NNSA.
Thank you. That's very important. I think the budget that hopefully the Senate will pass later today and the President will be able to sign will provide both the NNSA and the nuclear enterprise at large with the money that it needs to modernize its facility as well as our nuclear triad, but also to recruit and retain the personnel critical. That will obviously also be a leadership challenge for you and Secretary Perry and Secretary Mattis. But as I said, there's probably no more consequential job in the government than the one you're about to take. I appreciate your willingness to take it on. Gentlemen, I apologize that we didn't get to have an exchange, but best of luck to all of you as you move forward in service to our nation.
Thank you, Senator Cotton.